Opportunity is a unique thing. Sometimes it happens through, well, pure happenstance. Other times, something larger decides to give something its big break. But more fascinating tends to be the opportunity you made yourself. One that comes from seeing unavoidable adversity and taking a crack at it anyway. Often the scope or execution of these products are limited by their lack of funds, time, or experience, but I think they should be admired and looked at in spite of their flaws. Inside of Games and Out, we've all been in the thick of a difficult, unique, or uncomfortable situation. It's how you learn and develop from these ideas that's the important takeaway, even if they start out clunky and rough. And so, in the spirit of trying very hard and not quite coming out ahead, I present this dog.
So cute.
Secret of Evermore was a Squaresoft RPG released in 1995, 2 years after cult hit Secret of Mana. However, it has the incredibly unique distinction of being developed not by Square's home base in Japan, but the Squaresoft offices in the USA. Evermore was developed by a fresh team with everything to prove and not a lick of the background knowledge and studio culture that would go into developing Mana's actual sequel, Seiken Densetsu 3. Evermore was a golem, formed from the skeleton of Secret of Mana's ring menu system and weapon level mechanics, the flesh of pop culture and movie references, and the breath of a decidedly American sensibility about things. An ambient soundtrack composed by Jeremy Soule replaced the more melodically focused Japanese score. A Dungeons & Dragons-inspired alchemy system with limited charges replaced Mana's MP system, and likely most strikingly, the core draw of Secret of Mana, being a multiplayer RPG, was stripped out entirely for a single-player adventure. This would mean that said adventure would focus a lot less on shifting between three unique skill sets on the fly, and more on relying on your AI partner to do some heavy lifting, which honestly sounds like a nightmare. How would Squaresoft get around mid-90s AI foibles and prove themselves to the world? Dog. Secret of Evermore features two main characters. This hero with his Marty McFly jacket and Johnny Bravo hair, and a dog that shapeshifts to fit the environment that they're flung into. As it's game over when the hero dies, and switching between characters is never explained and it's pretty much just assumed you'll know how to by playing Secret of Mana, most players are gonna play as this dumb kid and leave the AI to control their dog. Already, this creates a very important psychological element. You are far less likely to blame a dog for being dumb than you are a humanoid character. I mean, it's a dog. He can't help that he kinda just wanders off following his nose. That's what dogs do. More importantly though, this tough pupper packs quite the punch, his strength far exceeding the hero's in almost every scenario. While the hero may be good at using his various weapons at a more extended range, they're pitiful compared to what the dog can accomplish by just running at and taking a bite into foes. And when you go to the future, he turns into a toaster that shoots laser beams. I mean, what's not to love? Well, most would probably say he's still run by a dumb-as-bricks AI, and they would be right. But Evermore knows this, and takes several steps to mitigate it. Firstly, the dog has special items in the form of dog treats that will revive him from death immediately. This keeps the player from needing to waste the rest of their healing items on the dog, so if he goes down, not a problem. Toss a treat into his mouth and he'll get right back to biting. Secondly, the enemy layout of Evermore is actually rather clever. Take Volcano Slopes, for instance. There are three major enemies here: a pitcher plant, a raptor, and some annoying spiders. The pitcher plant is an immobile foe, grabbing anything that comes in its path and sucking on them for a while. However, while it's digesting, it's completely open to attack from anything not actively being eaten. If the player runs into them, their canine companion will recognize it immediately, one-shotting the plant quite easily. And if the plant gobbles the dog up, the player gets safe passage through while the dog is able to fulfill its role as the team tank. The tight corridors of the slopes make the erratic raptors difficult to escape, but also make them equally easy targets for the dog to leap at, especially if the player joins in with weak swipes to keep the lizards in place. Spiders have some tricky timing to hit, doing a leap attack that avoids all physical strikes until they land, but dog isn't really that complex. So, see spider land, bite spider, spider die, good boy. By limiting the terrain around the AI and not making it as expansive as it could be, the dog is allowed to shine and potentially save the player's bacon more often than not. However, one feature best balances this good boy and turns him into a great boy: his sense of smell. At any time, the player can press a shoulder button to cause the dog to begin sniffing the ground. This allows the dog to track down alchemy ingredients hidden in the overworld, letting the player use more spells as,
"This might be a good spot to find some ingredients."
However, this has a very powerful secondary effect, locking the dog into place while he's sniffing. This allows the player to have limited control over their otherwise unruly mutt. Additionally, the targeting and action menus from Secret of Mana make a return, which allows the player to control how aggressively the AI will act, as well as what enemy it should focus on. This gives the player a great opportunity to stick the dog right out of their foe's range, to bait them, or directly into their range, willing to take a hit and ready to counterattack as soon as they make a leap forward. This is especially notable during the Salabog fight, a massive snake that would be difficult to hit if the player controlled the dog directly, but can be baited out by the boy, triggering the dog to automatically bite at it, dealing a massive chunk of damage. The player develops a relationship with the AI not unlike an actual pet owner and their dog, trying to guide them along the right path and relying on them to make the right choice and be the goodest of boys when the time comes. And that time doesn't always come, but when it happens, it's a wonderful feeling. Unfortunately, the rest of Secret of Evermore can't really live up to this, with incredibly powerful alchemy being totally missable and hidden in far corners, obnoxious hitbox shifting, a severe lack of invincibility frames, an obvious mischance built into every enemy's speed stat, supremely gimped healing items compared to Secret of Mana, a lack of any sort of tutorial or easier area to get the player to experiment, a lack of save points before boss encounters making repeating dungeons frequent. There are numerous problems with the game that makes it a chore to play. Heck, the first boss, the one on the cover of the game, renders the dog all but useless as its AI can't break through the boss's untargetable ribcage. Our fuzzy savior reduced a little more than aggro duty for some of the boss's maggot adds at best. It is absolutely Secret of Mana for super players, mixed with all the weirdness that comes with a first-time team handling a game. But that makes what does succeed all the more endearing. There are cute little moments and quotes aplenty, and in spite of my distaste for its moment-to-moment gameplay compared to Mana, oh, I can't stay mad at a boy this good who saved my butt so many times for too long. I don't enjoy it, but I get why this game is considered a cult classic by some, and I can see the work of a team just starting to figure things out. Much of this team would move on to humongous entertainment, with other members being shuffled around major video game publishers. And I have to feel that this first draft of what they could do led to a bunch of fruitful careers. And through the challenges of development, on the back of this little pupper, these guys showed how to design for opportunity.